Workshop 3, Saving for Your Children's Education. Hello everyone, this is Roancelis Capistrano of 1 Million Club. Welcome to our Financial Foundation Educational Program. Parents spoil their kids with toys and lavish birthdays, yet they have nothing into their college funding. Their popularity and their image to their friends take a higher priority than the future of their family. The person with responsibility knows where his or her priority is, their family's financial future. You must know what you want and what you need. You have a clear goal and a plan to achieve it. Oo nga naman, sa pagpaplano ng birthday ng anak natin, sinisigurado nating magiging maayos ang lahat. Mula ano ang ihahanda, saan gagawin, sino-sino iimbitahan, anong design ng cake, ano giveaways, ano mga games. When it comes to education fund, konti lang ang may plano. I'm sure you're one of the responsible parents, kaya you are watching this video. In planning to build education fund for your child, you have to consider these factors. First, inflation. Average of 5% per year. Meaning, ang tuition fee tumataas ng 5% per year. Second, time. Period to save money. Ilang years meron ka pa para mag-ipon? Third, rate of return. Interest on investment or savings. Very important factor, dapat ang kinikita ng investment mo ay mas malaki sa inflation. Here are the 25 of the most expensive private schools in the Philippines with 2015 to 2016 rates. Number 1 is Center for International Education in Cebu. Tuition per year is 330,000 to 420,000. Yung ibang school, nasa 200,000 per year ang tuition. Next, mostly, nasa 150,000 ang tuition per year. Rank 14 to 20 schools, nasa 100,000 per year ang tuition. Rank 21 to 25 schools, nasa 100,000 per year din ang tuition. Now, how to prepare for that? We have sample illustration here kung gusto mong makapag-aral sa top school ang anak mo. Assuming 100,000 tuition fee per year plus 150,000 for books, registration, etc., total education fund needed is 250,000 per year. So, using the present cost of 250,000 plus considering the inflation rate of 5% per year, after 10 years, ang value ng 250,000 is 411,752. Year 12, 432,818. Year 13, 454,962. And year 14, 478,239. Total education fund is 1,777,771. Kung 10 years pa ang time mo para maghanda or mag-save, you need 7,000 to 10,000 a month to hit your goal. Importante na nag-i-invest ka para mabilis mag-compound ang money mo. Dahil kung nasa bank lang yan or kumikita ng 1% per year, you need to save at least 14,000 per month. We have another illustration here kung sa other school mo pag-aaralin ng anak mo. Assuming 50,000 tuition fee per year plus 50,000 for books, registration, etc., total education fund needed is 100,000 per year. So, using the present cost of 100,000 plus considering the inflation rate of 5% per year, after 10 years, ang value ng 100,000 is 164,701. Year 12, 173,127. Year 13, 181,985. Year 14, 191,296. Total education fund is 711,109. Kung 10 years pa ang time mo para maghanda or mag-save, you need to save 3,000 to 4,000 a month to hit your goal. Again, importante na nag-i-invest ka para mabilis mag-compound ang money mo. Dahil kung nasa bank lang yan or kumikita ng 1% per year, you need to save at least 6,000 a month. So, why consider investing when planning to build education fund for your child? First is to outpace inflation, second to earn better rate of return, and third because you have financial goals. Financial independence is not a dream, it's a decision.
Again, I'm Roan Salis Capistrano. Kung nakatulong sa iyo ang video na to, share this video. And to know more about savings, investment, or kung gusto mong maging financial educator kagaya ko, visit bit.ly/1millionclub or email me at roan.capistrano@gmail.com.